But before Una ka itong ipugos na mukha ka, di ba? Mukha ka naman ka kay good morning ka. Matulog ka, katulog ka. Di na mga ginapugos matulog ka. Matulog mga ka, di ba? We have a choice. We have a choice on how we live, how can we live our lives. We have a choice to love our God with all our hearts and with all our soul. It was John 14:15 that if you love me, you will obey what I command. Matthew 12:34, for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So, sometimes we, ano, what we do sa itong life is, ano, we have friends, and sometimes, eh, pag-inestigay na sa itong friends, eh, basi ma-hurt na to sila, or ma-hurt na sila, pero, dili na to sila kaya i-confront, kay feeling mo, mawala ng friend. Or, siguro, sige na mo, ibakon yung t-shirt, eh, stick na kayo ng t-shirt, or, gainitan mo sa new t-shirt. Pero yun din sa Bible na, for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So, bakit pag usama ka plastic, kung usama sa mong heart, reflect na siya sa the way you talk. Kung ikaw ang person na depressing, na depressive ka sa world, bakit pag usama ka plastic, yung the way you act, makita ka sa mong actions. No wonder ka ano, nobody likes you or nobody seems to agree with you. Tungod na sa mong heart. Okay, you place in your heart anger ka sa world or bitter ka sa world. Okay, for I don't know for what reason you have, but bitter ka sa world. Ingon sa Bible, for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. In the Proverbs 18:21, the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. Meaning, what we say can hurt people more than siguro kung kulatawan na ito sa katao, masakitan siya, yes. Or sometimes, masakit ang words. I'm sure, familiar ang mga na, masakit kayo ang words. And sometimes we just, ano, baka no, magpaisog din ang takay. At kung ipakita na, dilig nung kasakitan, pero deep inside, you're hurting. Na joke dito pero sakit na nga kay affected din ako. Sometimes kita ang joke and the way we joke kay harsh din kayo pero tanggol control nakabigay na rin kasi tong friends or basi feeling na mo sakto yung gigon pero so ko na din yung parents mo bigil na. So we have to be careful the way we live our lives, the way we speak, the way we act, the things that we choose to look at. The way we speak, kung hilig kita o gossip, kita chismis, or hilig kayo mo, utana o porn. So mga guys, and, we have to be careful of what we do. Okay, it will poison us, it will poison your heart. But the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. So what's next? We have to, first, we have to love the Lord our God with all our heart and with all your soul. Next, we have to love the Lord our God with all your mind and with all your strength. At all minds is full of images, di ba? Even if imagine na isang word, kahit na word usually, na siya yun, natin gina-imagine na picture sa at all minds. And most of the time, siguro, half siguro sa day, we spend daydreaming about our crushes at sa itong mga uyam. Or siguro, the plano ka kung sa unang patay sa inyong teacher, kung sa unang cheat, or ambo, kung sa inyong mga hiramad ako lang karun, or feeling mo, umulkes ko niya, kaya maglaang isang barkada. Pero ang fact is, we spend most of our time thinking, or we spend most of our time in our heads. So kailangan, we have to love our God with our minds as well, and with all our strength. So how can we do that? I use the 1 John 3:18, dear children, let us not love with words or tongue, but with actions and in truth. Dali na kami yung sinong mo, I love you. But do you love her? Dali na kami yung I love you sinong parents, but do you really love your parents? Yes. Sure mo? Yes. Ingin sa Bible na, let us not love with words or with tongue, but with action and truth. Walk that talk. If you choose to say, I love you, make sure you mean it with your actions. Hindi kayo mag-ingulang ang I love you, mag-char-char na ka, eh, para makuhati ko siya or para buo kayo na kanaon sa mga parents, I love you ma, I love you pa, pero pagtalito day, gina-cursing mo yung parents, hindi ka ginapagawas o hindi ka ginatalag, basta ko kabaon. Diba? English Romans 12:2. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. So, what does this verse tell us? Do not be conformed in this world to this world. Meaning, dapat dilita mo adjust sa unsang gusto sa world sa tuwang life. Dilita mo compromise. Mo ka na, mubuhan lang ako sa lahat eh. Mumanili ko, mumanig ka buhatan sa tanan. Manigarili na lang ako, mumanig ka buhatan sa tanan. Mubisyon na lang ko, malaag na lang ko. O mag-cheat na lang ko, mumanig ka buhatan sa tanan. But the Lord says no. Yung si Lord, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed. Kailangan mabago ta by the renewing of our mind. Kailangan mabago ta sa ito ang minds. So that, ma-prove na ito na ang will ni Lord, which is good, acceptable, and perfect. Perfect. Okay, if we do not choose the Lord, our judgment will not be the best. Diba? If our judgments are the best, ano na may pain? Ano ka hurt man ta? Ano ka away mas ng parents? Ano na may war? Ano na may kagugom? Diba? Ano na may hutap sa SM? O sa bulwa? Ano na man ang mga hutap? Tungod kay we are not perfect. Tungod kay we have faults in ourselves. And those faults are the result of our sin. Okay, siguro, kapikita ng kalibat, kapikita ng kasit, disrespectful ka sa itong parents, disrespectful ka sa authority, lilit ka paminaw, kung kaya gestorya. Diba? Oo, guilty kayo, no? Lilit ka paminaw, kung kaya gestorya, or walang tayo respeto sa isang katao. And that is why, yung si Lord, do not be conformed. Ayaw sigot na inani na lang ka. Gusto niyo muna, inani lang ka. Or ang gusto ni Lord para sa mga, dire. Pero, pinapili niyo mo inani ka. Kasi hindi niyo pinapili si Lord. Okay, feeling mo si Lord boring. Feeling mo si Lord distrikto si Lord. Feeling mo si Lord, di ulilingaw si Lord. Or si Lord, okay, puro na basa sa Bible, puro na pray. Pero yung si Lord, do not be conformed to this world. Yung si Lord, let me prove to you that my will is perfect, is good, is acceptable. In Philippians 4:8, fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable and right. Think about these things, about things that are pure and lovely and admirable. Think about things that are excellent and worthy of praise. Let us reach for a high standard. Pero, kung mo, kuya, ang high na standard, hindi naman ako kaya. Kung ganun siya high na standard, hindi naman ako kaya. Pero, ang point, what the Lord is telling us in this verse is that we have to reach high, we have to aim high, because the Lord is with us. Yung si Lord sa word, kasi ang word, He will never leave us, He will never forsake us. And if we continue, if mapatayo na mag-think of things na excellent, mag-continue to think of things na honorable, mag-continue to think of things na maayos sa itong kauban, dito mag-think na, kaya niya siya ay mag-dita niya siya, o kaya niya siya nagpatiyo na kami sa uniya, or mag-cheat ko niya, or ang saba, or kaya niya ginako mama, kaya hindi ko ginakatagal ng baon, or hindi ko ginapakita ng bago sa hina, or hindi ko ginabakaon sa trio, or ang saba. If we continue to think of those things, kamuray luloy, kaya inyong life will be depressing, puno kayo ng anger. Pareha na sa fruit na, kung ang fruit at ang kasandal, hinay-hinay malata. If you continue to think of things na hindi maayos sa inyong lives, if you continue to think of things na gusto mo mag-revenge sa inyong friends or gusto mo mag-cheat o ang sabab, I assure you, your life will be miserable. Your lives will be lonely. Muna feeling ninyo wala eh, you're not seen in the world. Okay, you continue to think of those things. Pero yung si Lord, if you fix our eyes on it, if you fix your thoughts on what is true, the Bible is true, and what is honorable and right, think about these things, about things that are pure and lovely. If you choose to think of things that are dirty, if you choose to think of things of what to gossip, if you choose to think of those things, our hearts will be rotten, our minds will be rotten. Na ako lang tanaw sa babae kay sex object. Even sa guys, ang tanaw nyo sa guys kay kailangan ang perfect na guy kay macho, sweet, tanan, ano daw? Pero ang reality is, we are imperfect. And the reality is, we have faults in ourselves. Puno kita ng faults sa tong selves na we cannot imagine of showing our true self sa tong friends na sa balay kay naanay ko. Pero sa gawa sa balay, lahi ko. In Psalm 84 verse 2, my heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Dapat inana that our hearts and our bodies will have to cry out to the Lord. Okay, the Lord wants us to desire Him. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love the Lord your God with all your mind and with all your strength. Lastly, love the Lord your God by loving your neighbors as yourself. Meaning, or unsa man siya? Atong balikan naman, atong verse. Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is one God, is one Lord, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. So if you fulfill those first kailang anong two things na nadya, if you can do that, then I assure you, kaning last na thing, it will come out naturally. Kaning you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Natural na natin magawas sa inyong lives. Na if you love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength, natural na magawas na mo respect mo sa authority. Na mulibak mo tamo pero you will stop yourself. Or makikisis mo tamo pero you will stop yourself. Or muingin lang ka na, magkikatang ta kasi mong mind na, ano dili ko ginapalitan ng gadget o kanina cellphone. Pero you will stop yourself. Okay? You will remember to think of thoughts that are pure and lovely. You will think of thoughts that are honorable. You will choose to really pursue a very high standard. Dili tumo kay perfect mo, dili tumo kay kaya ninyo, pero tumo kay kaya ni Lord. Kaya ni Lord sa inyong lives na buhaton. Okay. And before we end, I would like to show to you a video which reflects on who we are sa our lives. I would like to show to you a video. I would really encourage you guys to really listen to the video, really listen to what it means in your life. And as you watch the video, I encourage you to really meditate on it and imagine na ikaw ang naa sa video. You will understand what I mean.
Ephesians 2:10 says that we're God's workmanship, His masterpiece. I don't know about you, but when I get up in the morning and look in the mirror, I don't really see a masterpiece, you know? I mean, maybe a Picasso. It's like, but I want to be His masterpiece. I want to be everything He created me to be. And so I go to Him in prayer and I say, Dear Heavenly Father, do whatever it takes to mold me to the image of your Son. Make me your masterpiece. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Hi.
Whoa. Who are you?
I'm God. You said the prayer, so here I am.
You're not God.
No, I am. You said the prayer. It's how it works.
Okay. If you're God, then make it snow in here.
You know what? I really don't want to make it snow in here because it'd get kind of yucky.
Yeah, you're not God.
Why do you say that?
God wouldn't say yucky.
I do. It's a Greek word.
Oh. Okay. If you're God, what does Lamentations 15:9 say?
Lamentations is only 5 chapters. It's a very short book.
Oh. Why was it so short?
I was tired of lamenting.
Oh. Okay. If you're God, who's going to win the World Series this year?
I'm really not playing games. Why are you so much into playing games?
You are God.
What gave it away?
You answered my question with a question.
I did? Yeah, I did that. Don't I? I did. That part up. Here we go.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, what are we doing?
I'm making my original masterpiece. This is the process.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Wait.
What are these about?
These are the tools I'm going to use to make you into my original masterpiece.
Okay. Maybe not.
Yeah.
I thought you were a carpenter.
That's my son. Step right up. Here we go.
Okay. Oh, hey, God. How do you know what to chisel away and what to leave?
I take out everything you like that doesn't belong there, kind of like dead weight.
Ooh, speaking of dead weight, could you chisel right here? It showed up when I was in my 20s and grew around and became a back fat. I don't even know why you created that, but I can't get rid of it. I mean, I've tried everything. Like, I tried running, I tried lifting weights. My wife actually talked me into trying Pilates. That was awkward. But I can't get rid of it, so if you would just chisel around here, and then, you know what, if you chisel a line right here, maybe four, maybe eight lines right here, that would be awesome.
You're funny.
You made me that way.
I also made the platypus.
The platypus.
All I'm saying is most of my children, when it comes to this process, they just want to talk, but they don't want to do the work. So do you want to talk or can I chisel? Talk, chisel.
No. I choose to chisel.
All right. Through my Holy Spirit, I'm going to bring up things in your life that I want you to work on. Like your anger. I created the emotion, but you use it in the wrong way. Compare yourself to others instead of me. You tell little white lies because you want to people please. You're lazy. But you try to fool everybody by looking really, really busy. You have a problem with lust?
Time out.
I don't really have a problem with lust. You don't have a problem with lust.
No, I can do it anytime I want. Hang on a second. I mean, I gotta admit, I feel like you've been doing some great work and I'm looking pretty good right now.
All right, when you look in the mirror, who do you see?
I see me.
Okay, then I need to keep chiseling away because ultimately you and other people need to see my son.
Okay, don't misunderstand me. It's just when I look more like Jesus, people get uncomfortable around me. I mean, even my church friends, and they're like, oh, you're holier than thou, you know? And I don't think it's supposed to make people uncomfortable.
So what you're saying is you'd rather play God in certain areas of your life than for me to be God over your whole life.
That is not what I said.
It's what you meant.
Yes, it is. It's hard to talk to you. You know everything that I'm thinking. I'm just saying you've done some great work. Maybe we take a break, a sabbatical from each other, you know? I'll stay right here, and then,
That's just that you never just stay right there. You're either moving toward me or away from me. Whenever you just stay. What you're doing is called control. Do you want to control things in your life, or can I chisel? Control, chisel, control.
No, chisel. Chisel.
All right.
But can we chisel where I want?
That's called control.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Now this right here, this secret sin that you keep running to whenever you're hurting, angry, lonely, tired, that you think you're fooling everybody, but it's making you a whitewashed tomb. Are you ready for me to chisel this out of your life?
Yeah.
See, it's a process. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. It's your whole life. You care so deeply about what other people think of you. It's rubbish. It's garbage. The greatest thing you're ever going to hear is at the end of your life when you hear me say, well done, good and faithful servant. That's what you keep your eye on. That's the prize. Heavenward.
This hurts.
Oh, trust me. This hurts me more than it hurts you.
Right. Okay. Sorry. I don't think you understand this pain.
Pardon me?
You're asking me to sacrifice a lot, God.
Don't talk to me about sacrifice. I know all about sacrifice. I sent my son to die on the cross for pain, for sin, but I also did it for another reason, to give you freedom. Do you know what insanity is? Insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over again, expecting different results. And there are things that you've been doing for years, these empty wells that don't have anything to offer. You've been going to them, and it's insane. Allow me to chisel them out of your life. Allow me to produce character when you keep focusing so much on your image.
Okay, but I was thinking.
Your thoughts are not my thoughts.
Okay, but if we went another way.
Your ways are
not my ways. Oh, I can't.
You can't what?
I can't be good.
That's your excuse. That's your excuse, is that you can't be good.
It's not an excuse. I can't.
Oh, my child. In the beginning, I said it was good. I made you good. Be good.
Yeah.
But you and I both. What? No, what is it?
Nothing, okay? You wouldn't understand.
I, God of all the universe, wouldn't understand something one of my children has to say. Try me.
It's just, I let you down so many times, God.
No, my child. You were never holding me up. I hold you up with my victorious righteous right hand. Never the other way around. In this relationship, I hold you up.
Okay. Chisel away. Just be prepared for what you're going to find out. Because I know what's inside there. Because I get up every morning and I look at him in the mirror and I hate who I see. Because deep inside there, this little kid who gets up every morning and dresses like an adult. And I go out and I try to do what I'm supposed to do, but I can't, okay? I can't be who everybody else expects me to be. God, I can't even be who I want to be, much less who you created me to be. And so inside is this scared, stupid little kid. But you chisel away. Just be prepared.
You have listened to so many voices for far too long that were not from me. And you have totally bought into the lie, haven't you? You think you're junk, don't you? When you lay your head down at night after you've done the dance to get the hug, you think you're junk. Listen to me. I don't take time to make junk. How can I show you that my love for you stretches as far as the east to the west? How can I show you that my love for you has no end? I know. Reach your back pocket.
What?
Reach your back pocket.
Why?
Are you arguing with me? Reach your back pocket.
God.
Yes?
I just been. God, I'll do that right now.
You're just saying my name in vain.
Come on, it's a name, it's a saying.
It's a name above all names. It's more than saying, it's more than name. I want to teach you something about my name. Reach in my pocket.
Oh, God.
Shh. You know what that is?
Yeah, it's a note. I wrote it when I was in college. How did you get this?
Hello?
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead and read it.
I love Angie.
Other side.
Sorry. Dear God, did I hear you right today? Did I hear you say that you love me? Even though you and I both know I messed up so many times. Did I hear you say you want to use me? And I feel so useless. And if you'll take me, then use me. God, I give you all that I am. Take me. I love you, God.
I love you too. And I love you too much just to leave you where you're at. This salvation that you hold, I don't want it to be some sentimental bush or some head knowledge. I want you to work it out in every detail of your life. And when problems come and chaos happens, don't look at that as a prison, but look at it as a father disciplines child. A father disciplines the ones he loves.
I know, but it's going to be tough.
Yes, but you bought into life thinking everything was going to be easy when you gave everything over to me. There will be trouble in this world, but be a good cheer. I've overcome the world. I want you to do something. I want you to look out there and I want you to say, Tommy is God's original masterpiece.
Tommy is God.
I love the way you see yourself and you try so desperately for others to see you, but maybe for the first time in your life, the way I see you, the way I created you.
God's original masterpiece.
Yes, you are.
And so are you. God doesn't make joke. You are the original masterpiece.
God loves you. God loves us. So you know, just like what the video said. Maybe when we are alone, we look at ourselves and we just feel dirty, we just feel broken, or we just feel so unworthy of anything in life. We feel na I am not worthy of love, or I am not worthy to be loved, or no one will be able to appreciate me. But the Lord loves you. But the Lord loves us. Marge, I would like to show to you a quote that I saw a few years back. It really helped me during a tough time in my life. And I would like to share it to you this afternoon. The most beautiful people I know are those who have known defeat, known suffering, known struggle, known loss, and have found their way out of the depths. These people have an appreciation, a sensitivity, and an understanding of life that fills them with compassion and a deep loving concern. Beautiful people do not just happen. When I first encountered this, it really felt like the Lord was speaking to me, that I did not just happen, that I am not just a human being in this world, that the Lord created me. And I would like to share to you this afternoon, the Lord created you. I would like everyone to close their eyes at this moment and just think about what you've been going through this past month. Think about the first topic of this series. Think about what you learned from that time, about prioritizing God, about choosing what priorities to prioritize. Think about prioritizing who God is in your life and what His role in your life is. And think about today. Think about loving God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The Lord is telling us, love me with all of who you are. Maybe you say, Lord, I don't want to love you because who I am right now is broken. Who I am now is dirty. But the Lord says, my child, I am hurting more. That you do not feel love. That you do not feel appreciated. That you feel that you are alone in this world. I am hurting that you see yourself as someone who is not worthy. I would like to tell you that I love you. The Lord would like to tell you that He loves you. We are God's masterpiece. We are His opera maestra. And who we are before God, that is the only thing that matters in this world. Not what our friends think of us. Not what we think of ourselves. But what the Lord thinks of us. And if you want to experience that love, if you want to experience the love that died for you on the cross, that bled for you on the cross, raise your hand right now. Raise your hand and claim it to the Lord. Claim it from the Lord. Lord, I claim your love. Raise your hand if you want to claim that love. If you want to know that someone loves you. Because someone loves you, that is God. Raise that hand and claim it to God. Lord, and if you want to pray that love, say this prayer with me. Lord, I love you. Lord, I am worthy, I am broken, I am a sinner. Yes, I cannot do anything without you, Father. But Lord, thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. Thank you for dying for my brokenness. Lord, I claim your salvation. I claim your love, Father. I thank you, Father, for God. The God who created the stars, the God who made the seas, the plants, the animals, myself because the pain deafens, Lord. The pain lessens the pain that I feel. Because I do not feel love. I do not feel appreciated. That I do not love myself. But Lord, thank you for loving me. Lord, thank you for loving me. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for who you are in our lives. Thank you, Lord. But I did not just happen. Thank you, Lord. That you created me in your own image, in your own likeness. Thank you, Father, that the fault in our in yourself, is not because of me, it's because of my sin. And Lord, remove my sin, Father, because you are my God, you are my King, you are my Master, and you are my Savior. Thank you, Lord, for who you are. Lord, may it not end this afternoon. Lord, may my life completely change. That others will see your love in my life. That others will benefit, Lord, from your love. This is how I benefit from your love, Father. Lord, may your name be blessed.